thank you for joining in today. Move to the restructuring candidate now, HCL Infosystems. Harsh Chitale, CEO of the company, has joined in. Harsh, good morning. Take us through the highlights of the restructuring plan and why you're attempting to do something like this.
Good morning. Over last 1 year, realized that we are operating many businesses in our one company which have different challenges and different priorities. For example, we have a large hardware solutions business that's going through a severe stress because of the situation that hardware industry is in. The market of hardware is not growing, it's getting commoditized, margins are under stress, and hence industry as a whole is in a phase of consolidation and making itself leaner. So that's a very different making yourself lean mindset that the team is working on that part of the business. At the same time, we have a large growing services business, which is almost now 800 crores a year, which needs aggressive growth mindset. Just to give you idea, that 800 crore is an Indian industry of almost 30,000 crore of IT services. So that's a phase where aggressive investing and growth mindset is needed. And then we also have a business of learning, which we believe is a future big bet, where the headroom for growth is very big. So there are three different mindsets needed, and we were trying to straddle all the three in one company operation. So one key requirement that we realized was bringing more focus and different management perspectives to each of these three. So this was one primary driver. Second driver for us was we also realized that hardware and services business need to be at arm's length distance, because services is a capability that we've created over last 2-3 decades, where we have presence all over the country to service different brands of hardware, and by it being closely tied to one brand of hardware, its capability, that capability was not getting fully leveraged. Now that the two become arm's length, there is a freedom to services business to go and also start servicing and providing service on other competing brands of hardware. So in a way, it unconstrains growth of services business. That's a second driver.
Good morning. I'm stepping in here because I imagine your investors want to understand the financial implications of this as well. In the first quarter, you did see stress both on revenues and margins. In this reformed entity, can you give us a sense of what kind of financial profile you're gunning for and what kind of revenue line the reformed entity has?
So the reformed entity is essentially about reforming our three businesses. So the hardware and solutions business is about 3,500 to 4,000 crore annualized business of ours. In itself, that's a business that today is EBIT negative. It's a business, that's the business that's going to need that cost takeout and leaning actions, which are underway, and those actions are expected to be completed in 3 to 6 months time. The services business is growing in double digits. With its separate identified focus, we expect that growth to...
Kevin, we've lost the audio temporarily with HCL Infosys. We'll just get back to them in a second. But the stock is up about 1% in reaction to the restructuring that they were talking about. The news came out yesterday. Harsh, we got snapped off for a second. You were telling us about the renewed revenue and profitability profile of HCL Infosys now.
Yes, so on the hardware and solutions business, on that 3,000 to 4,000 crore business, we expect cost takeout actions. That's a business which has been losing money for us. We expect actions of almost 50-60 crore of cost takeouts over next couple of quarters. And on services business, which is growing already at a healthy double digit, we expect that growth to accelerate further. That business is today a healthy, profitable business for us of about 800 crore. But as I said, that business is in a market space of 30,000 crore, and hence we expect significant headroom for growth with this renewed focus on services business.
The one criticism or concern about this learning and services line though, Harsh, is that it's been a bit unstable in terms of its revenue performance. Can you give us a sense of what kind of quarterly run rate you expect to churn out on learning and services?
Yes, so learning as an initiative we started 2 years back, it was about 23 crores first year, double to 50 crores second year. It's now already running at 100 crore annualized business. So we do expect this kind of growth momentum to continue. We've been investing in building the content needed for learning, and that investment phase is over. We acquired a content company 6 months back to give it a fillip in that effort. And hence, I think we are moving from the investment phase to now getting this business into its profitable territory. In next quarter or two, you would see learning business itself reach its critical mass and turn to profit. Where can it go? Learning is in India almost 150,000 crore market with very little technology enablement there. And hence, headroom for growth is big. Can this 100 crore be 500 crore, 1,000 crore, 3-4 years down the line? I would say the headroom is there. And now we are reaching critical mass that we were working towards. On the services front, some of our service deals have been lumpy. And our first focus has been in acquiring the services backlog. For example, you might recollect that some time back we announced one of the largest managed services win ever awarded in the country, which is the UIDAI managed services program. Now these lumpy deals come in and they are building up our TCV backlog of services, and hence it is appearing to be lumpy. But in terms of revenue recognition, I think it's a healthy month-on-month, quarter-on-quarter growth of service revenue accrual that we are building.
Just a quick two-part question then, Harsh. A, in terms of what kind of profitability profile the new HCL Infosys will have, in the sense what kind of bottom line targets you've set out for, and whether or not you will need to infuse any cash to get these systems and businesses going, and whether you'll have to raise any equity in that regard.
So let me take the last question first. While our hardware business went through a stress, company as a whole has been churning free cash flow, and free cash flow at a very healthy rate. Even through the lean periods of last 12 to 18 months, actually we were generating significant amount of free cash flow. And hence, in terms of cash, we are not constrained. We still have significant cash and cash equivalents on company's balance sheet. Hence, we do not see any need for cash infusion. And this restructuring is not aimed at cash infusion or seeking any fresh equity. Now let me take the first part of the question, which is about what's likely to be the margin profile. Services business operates at mid-teens in terms of its EBIT. Learning business, when it reaches its critical mass, is also expected to reach that kind of profit profile. Hardware solutions business, however, operates in very, very low single digit EBIT when some of their challenges are addressed. So these are the three very different margin profiles that we have in the businesses. As the proportion of these healthier, higher margin businesses increases with this renewed focus, we should see margin percentage of the business go up in quarters to come.
Okay, Harsh, we'll leave it there. Thanks for joining in. That's HCL Infosys talking about why they're revamping operations and what the new revenue profile might be. The stock has reacted well to that, up 4% in trade right now. The rest of the market sticky. Tata Motors, interestingly,